In this segment, we'll discuss about how to write VHDL code for full adder using structural style of modeling. Now friends, as you know, in case of structural style of modeling, we have to deal with component declaration and component instantiation. So we have seen in the previous video about how to write VHDL code for full subtractor using same style of modeling. Now let us start with full adder schematic. You can see it here. Full adder is basically a combinational circuit which has three inputs A, B, C, in, and it produces two outputs, namely sum and carry, which you have written sum and carry out. Now coming to the expression, sum will be A XOR B XOR C in, and the carry's expression will be product of AB plus BC plus A into C in. Now in case of defining the components, if you look after sum equation, here we need one XOR and two, that means total two XOR gates are required. And in case of carry, we required one AND, second and third. Three AND gates are required, and two times addition, that means two OR gates are required. So it will be a bunch of two XOR gates, three AND gates, and two OR gates. Now while defining these OR components and all these things, we have to internally generate certain types of signals. So we have written for the first case A XOR B, let the internally generated signal as S0. While coming to the product of AB, we'll generate the signal as S1. BC will treat it as S2, and the product of A into C in will convert it as S3. Now the addition of AB plus BC, which is nothing but S1 plus S2, will consider as S4. Now these internally generated signals are required in order to proceed with structural style of model. So let us start with writing the VHDL code for full adder. So first we define library terms as usual, IEEE, then we'll use it dot standard logic 1164 dot all. Now we'll come across entity declaration, which is full adder is port elements are there, A, B, C in going to be input standard logic, sum and carry is going to be output standard logic. We'll end the entity. Now we'll come across writing architecture. So we have written the statement as architecture style of modeling is structural of full adder is. Now let us come to define the required component. As we have seen, we required XOR gate, AND gate, and OR gate. So the first component we can declare is called as XOR 2 is with its port map. Here two input indicates there will be two inputs and one output. So let us consider AB as input standard logic and its output as C. We can take any variable instead of ABC, that can be acceptable. Then we'll end the component. Similarly, we'll declare the second component as AND 2 is. Again, it will accept two inputs and it will produce one output. We'll end it. Similarly, the third component required is OR gate. So it is written component OR2 is along with its ports AB input CS output. Now, here we have written the same input and output terms. You can write the other terms also as per your own wish. Once the component declaration is over, we have to move across component instantiation. So in case of component instantiation, if you carefully observe, so the first elements which will be required are going to be S0, S1, S2, S3, S4. Now these five terms are going to be bit type, therefore they are written as colon bit. Now we'll use them one by one. Let us start with the first statement, which is A, B as input and its output is going to be S0. So it is written as XOR2 port map A, B, S0. Now once this statement is executed, it will generate the result as S0 is equal to A XOR B. Then we'll come across another term, that is X2 colon XOR port map. Now in this case, we have the first input as S0 and second input as C in, whose output is going to be sum. So the terms are going to be S0 C in, or its output is as sum. So here the statement will be sum as A, sorry, XOR, S0 XOR with C in, or S0 humne already declared kiya A XOR B. So here it ends. Sum A XOR B XOR C. Now we'll come across generating the result for carry. Now to generate C out, first we'll fetch the product of AB, BC as well as AC. Let us start with the first product of A1. We are using AND2 port map with the input term AB and output is S1. So the result will be A into B. Next A2, AND2 port map with the first input term B, second as C in, and its output is S2. So it will generate the result as S2 is equal to product of B into C. Similarly, third product of A, C in, and its corresponding result will be S3. So S3 becomes product of A into C. Now we got three product terms AB, BC, AC. We have to add them. Now to add this, we'll use OR gate. So I'm writing the statement as O1 OR2 port map in bracket. Now here, AB product term is stored across S1. So the first input is S1. BC is stored across S2. Second input is S2. And its output is going to be S4. So S4 becomes equals to addition of S1 with S2. Now finally, we have to add S4 and S3. So the statement will be S4, S3 are input and its corresponding output will be Cout. So Cout is equals to S4 plus S3. S4 hamare paas hai, that is going to be S1 plus S2 and S3 is going to be A into C. So ultimately we have declared components and we have initialized them in a proper way. So based on that we got the two results. One is for sum and one is for can. Finally, we'll end the argument. So in this way, one can write VHDL code for full adder using structural style of mode. Thank you very much.